Hey, Dan Meyer here, and today we're back to talk once again about five tips for Filipino virtual assistants to land American business clients. Now, whether you're actually currently a virtual assistant, you're thinking about being a virtual assistant, or you're thinking about hiring a virtual assistant, I want to give you five tips that are really important. And this comes from my mentor, my business mentor, Bill Walsh. He teaches this methodology about how to really have a success blueprint. And I'm going to give you five tips from that blueprint in the lens of what a good virtual assistant should be doing to grow their business as a freelancer, as an entrepreneur, as well as what they can do to help a client grow their business. One of the disconnects I see a lot of is Filipino virtual assistants think of being a VA as just doing a job, like they're working for a big company. And a lot of times there's a big problem when you go into a job with a client who's a small business owner, entrepreneur, someone working by themselves with a very small team. They don't have the same mindset that you would find among management in a big company job. So you have to think more like your boss, more like your employer, more like your client to be successful. And this is a big, big challenge. So here are five tips that will help you. Number one is that you have to be the expert. The whole reason someone's going to hire you as a freelance virtual assistant is you have an expertise in a certain skill set. If you don't have that skill set and you're just a nice person with some general skills, they probably don't need to hire you. They're not big enough to have a bunch of people that can just do a bunch of things okay. They need to find people that can take away the pain, that can handle the immediate urgency, that can take on problems that they can't take on themselves because they're either too busy or it's not their area of expertise. So you need to be the expert. If you're a graphic designer, then you put graphic designer on all your stuff, on your Facebook, on your LinkedIn, on your profile, whatever you're doing, you're always remembering that you are an expert in what you do. And even if you're new to virtual assisting, you still have expert in things. If you use social media every day, you have expertise in social media. If you know how to make YouTube videos, if you're doing TikTok videos, if you have a page that you publish to every day on Facebook with photos and images and whatever you're doing, then you have some skills, right? So everyone's got some experience. Bottom line, though, is you have to be the expert. A lot of people that are going to hire you are only going to hire you because you are the expert in what they need. Number two, you have to be empowering. You have to give people hope. You have to show people what you can do. You should have a Facebook business page as well as any other social media that you use to show how you deliver results, how you're going to use your story and your passion as a virtual assistant to help somebody else grow their business or launch a new business or do something dynamic because they're looking for someone that can do that. They're not looking for someone who can check off a few boxes, who can do a couple things. They want someone who's going to really help them grow their business. So you have to be empowering. You have to be hopeful, optimistic, show that there's going to be some progress made, and you can do this by having a lot of images on your social media. You can post quotes, you can post examples of things you've done, you can show yourself in action doing things that deliver results. But you should think about this every day is, are you posting something on your social media that may empower somebody else? And if you're doing that, then you're going to be much more attractive to a client. You're going to be somebody the client's going to say, hey, this, they get it. They know that they have influence. They know that they're doing something to be able to do more than just have fun. They're actually trying to further themselves. And that's important. Number three is get exposure. As a virtual assistant, you should be posting every day in Facebook groups. And it's maybe even LinkedIn groups or wherever you think your clients are at. You figure out where they're at, you get in groups and you post, and you engage, right? You need to get exposure. You can go look at who are the best influencers in virtual staffing and you can comment. I'm amazed by this. I post something every day and I always see who sees my stories, especially in Facebook. And I can see who's not viewing them. Which is okay. People have a chance to view them. They're not, whatever. But what's really, really frustrated is the ones that do view it, but don't do something with it. I'm in a situation where I speak to small business owners on a daily basis. I'm always looking to find new virtual assistants to match up with American business owners. And if you're not taking advantage of that, of me to be your pipeline to work, why? Why are you not commenting, liking, sharing, trying to stay on the radar, not just for me, but everyone in my circle? If you post something on one of my public posts in Facebook, if you comment or you share or you like, you do something, you are in front of all of my friends, which are over 2,000 small business owners, coaches, trainers, speakers. You're losing an opportunity right there. And that's just me. Think about every influencer you could be following. So that's number three, get exposure. Number four, execute quickly. A good business owner knows how to execute. This is something I learned from Bill Walsh again about the importance of having not just a great idea, not just the fact that you're good at it, you are an expert, not just the fact that you can have a good message and that you're out there talking about yourself and showing what you can do, but you execute quickly. You have to be able to like show people exactly what you can do. It's all about timing. You got to be in the right spot, right? You got to be in the room, as Bill says, for things to happen. If you're not in the room, a virtual room or a real room, people aren't going to notice you, right? If you don't ask questions, the answer is always going to be no. These are things that you have to keep in mind. You have to figure out how to be ready. So have a 15-second elevator pitch of what you do as a virtual assistant. I'm a graphic designer. I know how to use Canva really well. I can build a brand for you. I know how to do logos. I can help you figure out your message and share it with engaging graphics. That's what I do as a graphic designer. That's my expertise. I can empower you and your business to be even more successful through my images. And I can help you get exposure by sharing what you do. And this is how we do it. I'm ready to go. Give me, set up for a meeting with me. Let me talk to you. Give me 15 minutes of your time to show you what I can do. That's how you execute, right? You go through what you can do. You talk about, what you're going to do, what you're good at, but then you have to have a plan. One thing you should always do is have a call to action, right? You should never post anything business related without some kind of call to action. Like right now, here's my call to action. Hit the subscribe button if you're watching this on YouTube. Please follow what we're doing. Drop a comment if you have any comments. Again, I don't get a lot of comments. I get 40 people watching the video. I get maybe 10 like it, thumbs up, but I get like one or two comments a week. And I go, so if there's all these people that are virtual assistants that say, really cool, thank you for posting this stuff, but they're not engaging in the comment section, I don't understand. So you're losing the opportunity there. Okay, number five, last one. I'll finish up on this. You have to be successful to attract people, right? Be so successful, you attract people. You have to be this way. You have to promote yourself as successful. You have to talk about yourself as you're successful. Even if you're not quite there yet, you're on your path, and you have to attract people by your success. If you do things and you show things and you demonstrate things, you will attract people. So you need to figure out that for your success blueprint, right? You need to be the expert who's out there every day talking about what you do in an empowering way, showing that you can take quick actions in a way that attracts people because you are talking about your own success. And as soon as you get a client, you take these same lessons and you apply it to their business. So I hope that helped. I'll be back again in a few days with another video about how to land an American client. Again, subscribe to the channel below. Feel free to find me on social media and let's chat about what we can do to help you level up as a virtual assistant. And or if you're looking for a virtual assistant, I can find the one that's perfect for your business. So thanks for your time. Now go out there and have an amazing day.